Hey everyone, and welcome back. Today we're going to be doing something just a little bit different. As you might have noticed from watching past videos or if you follow me on Instagram, watercoloring is one of my favorite pastimes. I took it up just under a year ago and quickly fell in love with the medium. So today I figured I would take you along for a little paint with me. I'm definitely not an expert watercolorer. I am very much still learning, but I've had a lot of fun experimenting and finding my own style. And I've discovered that I really love the combination of ink and watercolor. So that's what we're going to be using today. And as for our subjects, we're going to be painting some daisies, which are my favorite flower. And the first thing that I like to do before even beginning painting is to find something to draw a reference from. Often I'll use a physical object in our home for a reference, but other times I'll use Pinterest or Google to find images that I can draw inspiration from. So today I'm going to be using a combination of three different reference pictures to create my own image. First, I found this close-up picture of a couple of daisies and I really like how it shows the shape of their leaves in close detail. Then I also have a picture of some daisy buds because I want to add at least one of those to our image. And then the third picture is this botanical illustration. Now, I'm not wanting to copy the actual style that it's done in, but what I really like about this image is the general placement of the daisies. I really like this look of having multiple interwoven flowers because it creates a feeling of balance in an image rather than just having a single bud. So those are the images that I'll be referencing for this painting, but my goal is really to inject my own style into it. Okay, and the last thing we need to talk about before we get into the actual painting is the supplies I'll be using. So first, I always like to sketch out whatever I'm planning to paint in pencil first, and for that, I just like using a 2H pencil because it goes on the paper really lightly and doesn't show up in the final drawing. And then ink is really tricky when it comes to watercolors because you need to pick the right kind of ink so that it doesn't bleed through the paper. I love these Pigma Micron pens. I'll be using the 03 and the 005. What's great about them is that the color goes on really boldly and doesn't bleed. Then for the actual paints, I started using these Grumbacher watercolors a few months ago and really like them. For my brushes, I'll be using a couple from this Transon watercolor brushes set. They're really affordable and work great. And then finally, the paper is also really important to consider when watercoloring. If you use regular paper, it doesn't actually absorb properly and can tend to wrinkle up the paper. So you can really use any kind of watercoloring specific paper, but the paper that I'll be using today is from the brand Canson. But I think that's it, and I'm excited to get to painting. So if you haven't already, be sure to hit that subscribe button below and let's paint. All right, well, let's start painting, or I should say sketching. I always like to start out by drawing out my paintings before I ever put ink or watercolors to paper. Pencil is just a lot more forgiving, so it's a lot easier to cover up any mistakes in this first stage. So I'm just starting out by sketching out the flowers, using my reference images as a guide as I do so. When it comes to drawing flowers, I always like to start at the center and then work my way out. So I'll start with a little oval in the center for the daisies and then work my way out, drawing imperfect petals. Nature isn't completely symmetrical, so it's important to mimic that in our drawing. Some leaves may be hidden, others are a bit larger or smaller, and so as much as possible, I like to capture that. My particular art style isn't hyper-realistic, but details like that can help to capture the essence of whatever you're trying to draw. I don't make my sketches super detailed though. Normally I'm just going in and creating basic shapes, and it's only when I start putting ink in the page that I'll begin filling in more of those details. First though, I will begin by tracing the basic outline I created. And as we fill these daisies in with ink, you'll notice that not only are the shapes of the leaves imperfect, but there's also a slight indentation on the outside of each leaf. When looking at my reference pictures, this is a detail I noticed and something I wanted to include in my final piece. And the stems were a bit of a tricky part too. I went hard with the idea of having overlapping stems, and because of that, it required a lot of care to make sure that I didn't have any stems going through any leaves. But this is where sketching everything out beforehand really comes in handy, because I was able just to trace over the lines I created. Once I finished with my 03 pen though, I switched to my 005 pen so I could add more detail. And the main things I was doing here was adding striation to each of the petals and adding detail to the center of the flower. Again, like with the petal shapes, you want the striations to be imperfect, going in different directions. And as I added detail to the center, I tried to add some natural shading to mimic how the light would naturally hit the flower. I love this stage of just adding in the finer details because I find that it adds so much depth and character to your art. And then once I was happy with the image, I moved on to adding color. you really use very little actual paint when watercoloring, so I tried to get out as little as possible from each tube. I did use quite a few colors though, because I find that the more that you use and mix, the more interesting your final piece is. And while I did that, I was actually giving the ink a chance to rest before going in with an eraser. This removes any residual pencil markings and just makes the final piece as polished as possible. But then it's finally time to mix colors and start painting. So getting some water on my brush, I began mixing the colors that I wanted to use for this piece. This is one of those parts of watercoloring that's really fun, but also that you can't do enough. The more colors that you mix together as you refine your final color, the more unique your piece is going to look on the other side. And so the first color I started with was just kind of a warm, neutral gray. Because Daisy's petals are white and I was working on white paper, I wanted to find a way of adding dimension to the leaves while still giving the impression that they were white. And so working with different shades of gray is perfect for that. And I concentrated most of my paint towards the center of the petal to give the natural impression of shading. And then for the center of the daisies, I mixed several shades of orange and yellow together, as well as brown, so that I could create a sense of depth in the flower. And when you use shading like that, it can really help to bring a two-dimensional image to life. And I really love this part especially, and it's easy to get lost in the painting process. This has become one of my go-to kind of relaxing activities, and I love doing it while listening to music or a good audiobook. Recently, I've been listening to the books Six of Crows and Crooked Kingdom, and I just love that combination of listening to a good story while painting. But then again for the leaves, I really took time with mixing the color, using a variety of lighter and darker shades of green so that I could create that impression of depth again. And after going over it with a basic color, I'll just tweak it and make slight changes until I'm happy with the result. And that's something that I love about art. It isn't a science, it's a journey, it's a process, and it's something that you can just have a lot of fun in the act of doing. Sure, the end result can be great, or maybe it won't be, but so long as you're having fun while doing it, I think that's the important part. It's something that you can have fun with and learn with, and over time you will grow in your artistic ability. And even if you don't become Picasso or Van Gogh one day, it's really fun to look at something that you made and just have that pride and ownership of saying, wow, I created that. And I just think that's so cool. But back to our painting. At this point, I have all of the basic colors filled in, and right now it's just about adding detail. And this part can be a bit tricky because it's all about just getting incrementally a tiny bit darker. It's important to remember with watercolor paints that it's easy to go darker, but it's really difficult to go lighter, so you want to build up that detail in subtle layers. One single stroke might not look like it makes a massive impact on the detail of a painting, but when you just add that incremental amount of detail multiple times, it really does make what you're painting feel so much more vibrant and alive. And when you do this ink and watercolor technique, you might notice, especially in areas where you've layered up the color, that the ink of your pen actually begins to fade a little bit. My suggestion would be not to worry too much about this though. What I'll often do is just touch up the ink where needed once my painting is fully dried. It's just the easiest solution I've found to make it so that I can just paint without worrying about it. Because at the end of the day, I paint to enjoy myself and to have fun, not to stress over the little things. But then once I got to a place where I was happy with the image, I stopped there. There are an infinite number of details you can add to any painting, but sometimes I find that if you go too far, you can actually ruin the image, or at least what you envision for it. So I called it a day, happy with my final piece. All right, well, thank you guys so much for coming along, and I really hope that you enjoyed today's little paint with me. I'm really happy with the little picture of the daisies we created. And if you create your own version of this image, I would love to see it. Be sure to tag me on Instagram. I'm at ashlyn.eaton on there. And of course, if you aren't already following me on Instagram, make sure that you're following me there, especially if you love watercoloring content. I tend to post a lot more of it on there than I do here on YouTube. But of course, if you aren't already subscribed here, make sure to do that too. That's everything for today's video though, guys. Thanks so much for coming along with me, and I'll see you in the next one.